We shall now try to take a look at a code where I am required to move the value of x to y and y to z. So for example, if x is 10, y is 20 and z is 30, I want x to be equal to 30, take the value of z, y to take the value of x which is 10 and z to take the value of y which happens to be 20. Now what has happened here is somebody has written a series of steps trying to do what the problem has asked. So using a test table, we need to verify whether this logic is correct or not. Almost certainly there is problems in this logic. But the best way to always analyze and understand logic is through a test table, because then you're very systematic, organized, and you're able to solve the problem very easily. So initially this is 10, 20 and 30. So what it's asking is, the value of x should go to y. This fellow should become 10. The value of y should go to z. And x should get the value of z. So it's kind of this fellow going here, this fellow going here, and this fellow going here. Now there is a code written for that. Let's try to run through the code and find out what are the problems. So here on the green you have the steps. So x is 10, y is 20 and z is 30. In step number 1, what I have done is y's value is copied to x. So x also becomes 20, y becomes 20, z becomes 30. Here itself you will have noticed the problem. We have lost the value of 10. Now next step, y takes the value of z. So y becomes 30, z is also 30, x is 20. Now z takes the value of x. Since z takes the value of x, z is 20, x is 20, y is 30. This is step number 4. So when I am printing the value of x, it is 20. What should be the actual value of x? The actual value of x, if you see here, the actual value of x should have been, actual value of x printed should have been 30. Okay, so let's write the correct value of thing. Alright, so this should have been 30, this should have been 10, and this should have been 20. So this should have been the correct value which should have got printed. But here we are printing in step number 5 the value of x as 20, so we have got the wrong value of x. Step number 6, value of y as 30, whereas it should have been 10. So this is correct, but this fellow is wrong here. Only z happens to be correct by chance. So this is the problem in the logic. There is a problem in the logic here because the person has failed to use a temporary variable. Now let's try to take a look at this particular code, or try to solve this code using a better approach. So in this approach, what I am going to do here in this approach is, I am going to use a variable called as temp. And then once we do the testing, things will be clear as to whether the result is correct or wrong. So first step, what I am trying to do here is, I am defining x as 10, y as 20, z as 30, and a variable temp which I have not given the value anything. Then what I am doing is, the value of y, I am keeping it in temp. Now no problem, because I have 20 in temp. So I can give y the value of x. So x is 10, y is 10, z is 30. Next step, what I do is, I give the value of z to x. I say x is assigned the value of z. So x is 30. Then last step is, z is given the value of temp. Temp had the value 20. So z got the value temp. Now if I print the value in x, y and z, now the exchange will have happened correctly as per the requirement. Okay, so the correct output should be, x should be 30, y should be 10, z should be 20. So we should move x to y, y to z and z to x. So as usual, without trusting our logic too much, we are going to use the test table to find out whether what we have tried or attempted makes sense and is correct. So what I'm going to do here is, I am going to use the test table test case. Alright. So step number 1, x is 10, y is 20, z is 30, temp, I have not given it any value. At step number 2, I give temp the value 20. That's why I've shown it in red. Then what I'm doing is, in step number 3, I am copying the value of x to y. That's why x has become 10, y has become 10, z has become 30. Alright? So, sorry, step number 2, I am copying the value of y to temp. So here temp has become 20. Now coming to step number 3. The value of x is given to y. Since the value of x is given to y, x is 10, y is 10, this is 30 and this is 20. Step number 4. Z's value is given to x. So x is 30, z is 30, y is 10. Alright. Now step number 5. I just have to give the value of z the value of temp. So what I am doing is 20 is copied into z. That means z is assigned the value of temp. Then here in step number 6, I am printing the value of x is 30, which is correct. Y should print as 10, which is also correct. And then finally, z should print as 20, which is also correct. So here if you see, this is the correct output. Whereas the logic written by whoever XYZ it was incorrect because he or she failed to use a temp variable. One or two more suggestions. We easily did this using a single temp variable. Some of you may have attempted using two temp variables, three temp variables. If possible, avoid that. Solving a problem is not only finding a solution, but also finding the solution in the best or the most optimal manner. Because in this fellow, I am using only one extra memory location. If you use temp 2, temp 3, you will use more than one memory location. Not that it is wrong. In fact, there is absolutely nothing wrong with it. The beauty of logic is everybody's thought process is going to be different and going to produce different results. But you should try to use minimum resources and most systematic steps to get the output. So I hope this clears your thought process of what was wrong in the logic and how we got the right answer. Re-emphasizing, creating the test cases and the test table is simply the best way to understand programming logic.